So, good morning. We're working on a 1976 Grumman Tiger today that's having an issue with its flaps. On each of your flaps, there is a rub strip. And these are pop riveted to the flap, and they rub against the rubbing strip and the spar on the back of the wing to allow the flap, when it's deflexed due to the air load on it, that it'll retract properly and not bind up against the upper airfoil. Well, as you can see, as it's rubbed over the top many, many times, it's worn off the countersinking off the top of the rivets and has delaminated on the left-hand side. We find something we've not seen before. It is, again, it's a rub strip on the wing. Unfortunately, you'll notice this one has no rivets. It's simply been glued with some sort of epoxy, which is breaking loose. And you can see the broken gap. So this one will be taken off. We're going to have to remove the ailerons, the wingtips, and the flaps from the aircraft to completely debond that, and then remount it without any glue with four rivets in the corners. And we have the new rivets for each of these. These are the new 5203018-8 rub strips, new from Fletcher. We got two of them. We have two of them in stock, and we also have the specialty countersunk 1604-0414 countersunk steel rivet, aluminum rivets. The first part of getting at the flaps is removing the wingtips from the aircraft. And so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take off the 23 screws on the right wingtip and the 22 screws on the left wingtip and remove the wingtips. We'll be back in a minute to video removing the strobe. Now, as you remove the wingtip, as you can see, we've removed all the 22 screws. Up here in the front, we're going to want to take loose the nav light from its connector. So we're going to remove those two wires. If you've got the LEDs, they'll be polarized. And then finally, we're going to take loose the connector on the flap strobe. It's a Molex 3-pin connector. And then the sliding out over the... All we have left to fight with is a ground wire. And this one is held on with a wrist hand. And so as you can see now, we have the wingtip laying on the carpeted floor. And we've removed the strobe from the strobe plug, the nav light plug, the ground wire for the system, the power supply for the strobe unit. And now we'll be going after the bracket to remove this portion. But before we do that, we're going to go remove the other wingtip. And we're going to get into the hell hole and release the ailerons so we can slide the ailerons out. Notice too that on this particular aileron that it's already had the oversized bearing installed. That's a stainless steel sleeve, so it's got the dash 4 bearing on it, and good. So just like the other wingtip, we're going to disconnect the strobe from the power supply. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is get access to the hell hole. That means the two front seats are slid all the way forward. We undo all the seat belts in the back. Okay, once the rear seat backs are out, then the easy part is to reach down and grab, where I can see it. Grab the bottom of the seat and roll it forward, transitioning back out of the airplane. Bringing the front seats forward allows this one to come all the way up. And now we're only now have to access the canvas cover. And finally, we've got the hell hole exposed. We've removed the snapped cover. The front's held in by screws on this particular aircraft. And down here where the aileron torque tube comes all the way in, get enough light down here, we get to the point where we can see that we have the aileron bolt that hooks to the control arm. It's held in by a 1A and 4 close tolerance bolt. We're going to remove that, which when we take the bracket loose from the outside will allow the whole torque tube to exit out. We'll do the same thing on the other side of the aircraft. Okay, now that the aileron torque tube has been freed up on the inside of the aircraft, no longer connected to the controls, we can remove it from the aircraft. We're going to begin that process right here by removing these two A and 4 bolts, which hold the counterweight, and also through the aileron stop, which control the throw of your aileron on this side of the aircraft. We'll go ahead and remove those A and 4 bolts, and then we're going to attack the bracket right here. And as a final reminder, if you look on the top of this aileron, you'll see that I've taken a Sharpie and written up on the counterweight. We're going to be having both ailerons and both counterweights off the system. And though they'll be on different sides of the hangar, we want to make sure there's no chance of putting the aileron counterweights on backwards, because they will fit, but they will greatly restrict your movement, and you'll be having counterweights sticking out in the slipstream. So you want to make sure they go back on the correct side of the airplane, which is why we always label the top. Finally, moving on to the aileron bracket, which will be the final thing before pulling the aileron, we're just going to go ahead and remove these two A and 3 bolts with 3/8 inch sockets. So here we are back in the hell hole again. I want to point out the flap, the aileron torque tube, which normally comes out of the flap. And as you can see, on this side of the aircraft, it still does. Flap motor, flap bracket. So the aileron torque tube is now out of this side of the airplane. Let's point out what's left in the pork chop. To remove the flap, this is the flap torque tube inside of the pork chop. This is the pork chop, the round thing. We're going to first undo the two pinning bolts, this one and this one, which have a special shape. And then finally we'll release the band clamp on the bottom, which releases the pressure on the torque tube, and we'll be able to slide it out of the aircraft. So to get after the pinning bolts, easiest way is with a ratcheting 7/16. You simply put it in. It breaks loose fairly quickly, and then it's a matter of spinning it out by hand. Now you don't need to take it all the way out, but I am going to take this one out just to show you what it looks like. It's a bolt. Looks a little bit different. Got a little tab. That tab actually goes through the torque tube. Goes through the torque tube on the flap, which holds it in place and allows it to rocking. There's one on each side. And if we look right down in here fairly closely, we can see the other one sticking through the torque tube at about dead bottom. Now we'll go ahead and remove that one. Okay, and now that the flap has been completely removed and the bracket has been taken off on the outside edge, we've removed the outboard bracket, which bolts in here. We have a special tool we use for that. Not needed. Sure makes it easier. And there's the flap laying on the floor, bracket on one end, torque tube on the other. We'll clean up the torque tube and all before we put it back. If you looked at our aileron bushing, replacing that here on the flap, this is the flap bracket bushing. It's on the outside bracket. It's right here. There's another one right on the inside of the honeycomb inside the hell hole. So a lot of people miss that one. A lot of people miss this one. But this one's in really good shape. Flap brackets, the dash 2, the 902013-2 bearings. Well, one of them is right here, stuck right in the end of this side of the flap. And of course, there's one on the other end underneath the horn for the flaps, which we won't show because we're not going to disassemble the flap. But that gets the flap out of the airplane and allows us to go ahead to begin work on that rubber. And this is the special tool we make to remove those AN3-4 bolts, that 4A bolts that hold in the flap. We took a scrap 3/8 inch socket. We cut it down till it just barely fits over the head of the nut. We actually reduced the diameter a little bit with some filing so that it can fit in over the flap bracket, get on the head of that AN3 and spin it out and spin it in. You can do it with an old ignition wrench. It's just a lot of steps, a quarter throw, you know, 12 throws to get it around a full turn. You can be there for quite a bit of time removing this bolt. So this tool makes removing. All right, here we are getting ready to take out these two bolts using a special tool. You'll notice that it just goes in around the side of the bracket. And runs the bolt right out. And that is... Okay, now we're ready to assemble the new flap. We've drilled out the old one. Here it is in all of its worn glory. The new one simply lays on the wing, and then to get it positioned, you put in two of the diagonal rivets. Once that's in there, this really can't move. Add the other two. And again, these are 1604-0414 countersunk 1/8-inch, 1/4-inch grip AVEX rivets. So now the rivets are in place, and we'll proceed to pop the rivets. All four of the rivets are in the rub strip, and this flap, I'm going to do a little cleaning here on the back edge. We're also going to clean the back channel on the aircraft since it's very rarely exposed like this. Then this flap and aileron will go on. We'll do the other side, and this airplane will be done.